What's up guys, we are Mobile Network Comparison and today we've got a full tutorial to show you how to install the custom VIBE ROM for the Lenovo A850. So the VIBE ROM is a pretty cool custom ROM. It's actually ported for a ROM designed for the S650 Lenovo phone. It looks really cool, we'll show you some of its features, and best of all, it's actually a really lightweight version. So it removes all the excess apps, it doesn't even come with any of the Google apps apart from the Play Store, which allows you to download whichever ones you want to choose, so it's not got any bloat. It's also got root, it fixes some errors in translation of some of the applications, and it allows you to move apps between your data partition and your external SD card. And you can use BusyBox on it as well. So overall, it's just a great alternative to the default ROMs available for this phone. The way we're going to install this ROM is via a custom recovery, but to get to that stage, we actually have to change the existing ROM on the phone by flashing a new ROM across. It's a little bit complicated because the rest of world ROW ROM that the phone comes with isn't the correct base to flash across a new ROM by recovery. So we need to get a different ROM across first before we can do it. But this tutorial will show you exactly what you have to do at all stages. And the first step is just to turn off the phone, power it off completely, and take the battery out. Then you're ready to get started and flash the first ROM across with the flash tool. In order to flash the new ROM, you need three things. You need to have the USB drivers installed in your computer so it can see your phone. You need to have the flash tool application. And of course, you need the ROM file itself. So if you click on the description below, we've got a link that will take you to our site, where we have all these things prepared for you. So we've got a zip file with the flash tool and the USB drivers inside it. We've got a zip file with the ROM inside it. And we've also got USB DView should you need it if you're having trouble installing the USB drivers. So once you've got all that sorted, you're ready to start the flashing process. Go to your computer, navigate to the flash tool folder, and then just go ahead and we're going to run the flash tool executable. So double click it, hit run, and it will open up. And once it's loaded up on your screen, the first step is to load the scatter file. So just click here and then double click on the scatter text file that was included in your ROM dump, which you have unzipped somewhere on your computer. And then we need to check this box that says DADL or with checksum. That's very important. And just check some options before we start it. So check USB mode is on and check that the speed is set to high speed. So before we go ahead, never ever press this format button, be really careful. You always want to click the firmware upgrade button or click F8. Once you hit that, you'll see searching appears at the bottom and it's ready for you to go ahead and plug in your phone to the USB cable. So I've plugged the phone in and I'm just going to quickly fast forward through all of the ROM being loaded onto the phone. So we actually have a complete tutorial video just for flashing this first ROM across. And if you've already followed that, then you don't need to do the step. You can skip straight to booting into recovery and flashing the VIBE ROM across. Just make sure before you boot into recovery that you've copied the VIBE ROM zip onto your phone somewhere so you have somewhere to install it from. It shouldn't take too long at all. You'll probably be looking at a total time in the region of about 5, 6, or 7 minutes once everything's done. As long as you're seeing coloured progress bars along the bottom, everything's running fine. And you just need to make sure you've got a decent USB cable that's reliable and that will last without any problems. So now we've got to the end of the flashing process here. This big green circle means everything's done correctly. You can close it, close the flash tool, and then unplug your phone. So now this is done, you can either boot into the ROM itself, which will take a little while, and from there use something like Mobile Uncle Tools to boot into recovery. Or just do what we're doing, which is holding down the power key and the two volume keys from power off. And that will boot us straight into recovery where we can begin flashing the VIBE ROM. So once we're into recovery, we can just navigate through the menus by using the volume keys to go up and down and the power key to enter our choices. We need to go to install zip from SD card and select that option. And then we can choose the zip from SD card and navigate to the zip file. Press yes to confirm our choice and it will begin flashing across. So I'm just going to fast forward through this process. It's actually pretty quick flashing a ROM from a zip. It's just going to copy all the files across, unzip everything and make sure everything's flashed to your phone. So before we actually attempt to boot up into the ROM, we just need to do some housekeeping to check that it's going to boot up correctly the first time. You want to just choose go back and then navigate to the option saying Wipe Data Factory Reset. Press yes on that. It'll take a few seconds just to wipe these couple of partitions. And just to be sure, we're also going to wipe the cache partition manually by selecting that and pressing yes, wipe the cache. And finally go to the advanced menu and wipe the dalvik cache as well. And once that's all done, we're ready to go back to the main menu, press reboot system now, and check out our new VIBE ROM. So as always, the first boot takes a little bit longer than usual, but it shouldn't be too long at all. And before you know it, you'll be using your phone with your newly installed custom ROM. So just give me a second while the phone boots up. I'm just going to fast forward through this because it takes about 30 seconds. And we're done, and it's going to start loading the desktop for the VIBE ROM. So as you can see, it looks quite a bit different from the last ROM we had installed on this Lenovo A850. Before we get started, we've got to just quickly accept the license agreement. So scroll down to the bottom and hit this accept button there. And I'm going to skip the settings wizard this time, and this is what the ROM looks like. So you'll notice that we've got root automatically, as well as these quick settings icons in the notification drawer, which give you quick and easy access to various settings and options. So let's go forward and have a look at the settings pages. Again, it's split over three pages, and if we scroll down to the bottom here and have a look at About Phone, you can see the version info, and we are running VIBE ROM version 1.0 for the Lenovo A850. The phone comes with various tools installed and minimal amount of apps. Let's look at the messaging interface. So it's a little bit different from the other Lenovo interface, as is the context. And the dialer is nice and clean and easy to use and looks pretty good actually. As we mentioned earlier, it includes the Google Play Store, but no other Google apps, so you have the choice of whether you want to install them or not. And unfortunately, one of the biggest flaws with this ROM at the moment, as it's still in development, the camera doesn't work, and nor does the GPS. So you just get this green screen here. But let's go and look at those settings again. So you've got all the normal options here, like Wi-Fi, brightness, wallpaper, some feature settings, and of course, settings like setting up mobile networks, and all the other things that come with Lenovo phones. The great thing about the VIBE ROM, you can finally move apps to the SD card. Really, really useful. And we've still got the fantastic SIM management software, which allows you to use the dual SIM capability. As well as that, we've also got scheduled power on and off in the settings, which is a really useful feature. And again, let me just show you some of these tools. So for example, the clock, again, pretty standard Android clock. And a little bit more about these quick settings options. So you can scroll backwards and forwards between them, and it's even got, as well as that, a quick settings panel, which let me just activate that, and that gives you even more settings to choose from all at once in a quick and easy way rather than having to navigate through menus. VIBE also comes with a theme suite, which is its way of allowing you to customize the look and feel of your phone in quite an easy way. So you can see there's a handful of choices here for us to pick from, and they actually quite drastically change how all aspects of the interface appears to you. So let's have a look what this one looks like. Go back to the home screen and you can see it's completely changed. Let's pick another theme to see how that looks. This one looks quite fun. Just quickly activate it, and this is what it's supposed to look like, and then you can see even all the icons are styled in a new way. So that's been our tutorial to installing the VIBE custom ROM on the Lenovo A850. As usual, all the details, full explanations for what to do, and links to all the downloads you need will be in the description below, just below that thumbs up button. Thanks again for watching, we hope this has been useful. Please, please let us know how you get on, and we're also really interested to hear what you want to see from us in the future. So whether that's more unboxings, more reviews, ROM install tutorials, or anything else, please just let us know with a comment and subscribe to check out more of our videos in the future. Cheers!